What is up, guys? It is Carly here bringing you another weekly dose of horror, and today I'm going to be talking about Cloverfield from the year 2008. Now, Cloverfield, this is essentially a found footage disaster monster type of film that is supposed to take place in New York, and it's surrounding this group of people who are pretty much at this party, and you know, everything is completely normal when they're kind of just videoing things for the heck of it, I believe. And then all of a sudden something goes horribly wrong, and the town starts to, or you know, all of New York City starts to just fall apart because there's this monster of sorts that lands down and is destroying everything and killing people, and just all hell sort of breaks loose. So this specific group of friends, they decide, you know, to keep filming everything that's going on as they try to track down their one friend in the process and save her because she's in this different location, and they're also just, you know, trying to get to safety in general. So that's kind of the idea with this one. I'd only seen this movie once before, a few years ago, probably when 10 Cloverfield Lane came out, actually, because I wanted to see that one. So it was back when I first started collecting, really, and getting more into horror, and I remember I liked it. I didn't think it was overly great. I remember, you know, I know this is one that's kind of controversial, whatever, because some people, you know, think it makes you sick because it's so shaky, and then other people seem to really like it and think it's pretty scary. You know, I'm kind of just like, eh, on it. Like, I don't think it's a great film. It's not that it's a bad film, it's just not something that I would really run back to. I don't mind found footage films. They've grown on me over time, and I feel like a lot of people kind of feel the same way, where, you know, at first found footage came around and not everyone was super into it, but now you realize that there are some good ones out there. I would consider this a good one, but at the same time, there is some of the shaky footage. I don't really have a problem with feeling motion sickness or anything like that. I just feel that it makes it a little hard to get into the movie and enjoy what's going on. And I get why they did it, because, you know, you don't really ever see the monster head on or anything like that. You kind of just see brief glances, and then all of a sudden the people will be running, or it'll get dark, or like a building will fall or something like that. So it's supposed to build suspense because you never really get to see what's going on, and it's all just meant to be chaotic and try to be realistic in that aspect. So I do think they do a good job with that. The performances from the characters are pretty good too. Obviously, found footage, you know, it's not real, but I think these characters are pretty believable. You have a lot of emotional moments where they're just like, why is this happening? What's going on here? And it does, you know, it is kind of depressing. These types of movies do bring me down to just see the world being destroyed all of a sudden. You go from your normal life to everything is just chaotic, and you're trying to survive, and all you're doing is trying to survive, and there's really nothing else to live for besides not dying. So if that made any sense. So I think they do a good job with those aspects. It just is a little bit too dark and shaky at times for me to really get behind the story as a whole. And it is a basic story, though. It's not like there's a ton you have to follow. But at the same time, I like being able to see what's going on. That's my only issue, really, with found footage films, is when it's actually legit footage that someone is filming with their hands. It can get a little sloppy, as opposed to, you know, something like Paranormal Activity, where they're just filming themselves sleeping and, you know, things like that, so the camera's steady a lot of the time. So I do have problems with that, but overall I think it's a decent film. Back on the emotional part, there is I think the way it ends is actually pretty sad as well, and I like they do sort of this thing where it's kind of like the old reality versus the new, and it shows like old footage of this couple before all this happened. And I like that aspect. Once again, pretty depressing, but pretty well utilized. But overall, I'm not a huge fan of this movie, but I do think it's good, so I give it a 7.5 out of 10. Thank you guys for joining me for this week's weekly dose of horror, and as always, I will see you next week.